In this mode of vibrations, first diagram we consider, second diagram and third diagram. For first diagram, that is a figure A, B, C, here I mentioned here. Now, in this first mode of vibration, the amphibian nose is always from at the rigid point. That's why here total two node is formed, and at the center of it, there is a one amphibian node is formed. Okay, now after that we draw the diagram of the wave. Antinode is formed at the center, like that the wave is, we draw here antinode and then it will be formed here. This is an incident wave. After that this wave is reflected, and then after the reflection of it, it will be formed the one loop. Okay, one loop is formed. And then this is a stationary wave, incident ray, reflected ray, interfer of it, it will produce the stationary wave. The length of this string is denoted by L, and the half of the flow in terms of the wavelength is denoted by lambda by 2. Got it? Length of the loop is denoted by L, and the wavelength in terms of wavelength, if I measure the distance for the one loop, is always taken as a lambda by 2. How it will become? If I draw the one form of wave, this is a one form of wave, is there? This one form of wave is having the distance is lambda, that is a one wavelength is there. And if the wave is reflected, loop like structure is formed. When the loop-like structure is formed, the length of this one loop is lambda by 2. This will becomes as lambda by 2, this will becomes as lambda by 2. Therefore, for this one loop, I mention here lambda by 2. Okay? In this mode of vibration, first mode of vibration, figure A, in that case, in figure A, we consider the frequency, let L and lambda be the frequency and wavelength of wave. In a first mode of vibration, we mention here frequency is L, lambda is a wavelength of it. In that case, velocity is equal to, already we mentioned that, which is equal to T upon M. Next is that velocity basic formula is there in terms of frequency and wavelength, that is n into lambda. What is the value of the frequency? Frequency is equal to v upon lambda. Got it? V, n is equal to v upon lambda. Now just simply substitute the value of the v, that will come here the 1 upon lambda into under root of v upon n. Now we got the formula for it, n is equal to 1 upon lambda under root of T upon n. Got it? In first mode of vibration, frequency of the wave, in that case n is equal to 1 upon lambda under root of T upon n. Now we are using the simple formula for it, length of one loop. See that simple formula, length of one loop is equal to half of the wavelength, that is lambda by 2. Okay, simple formula is there, that is the length of one loop is equal to lambda by 2. Or we write here, see the, from here we start, length of one loop, length of one loop is equal to lambda by 2. Now what is that length of one loop? Here in first mode of vibration, length is L. That's why here we mentioned L is equal to lambda by 2. What is the value of the lambda? Lambda is equal to cross multiplication 2L. Now substitute this value into this formula for it. That is N is equal to 1 upon lambda. Lambda becomes as a 2L under root of T upon M.
and this is a very important formula for the fundamental frequency. First mode of vibration frequency is there, that this is called as a, this is fundamental frequency. Okay, first name is there, it is a fundamental frequency. Second name is given here, it is an integral multiple of the fundamental frequency, that is a one number is there, that is, it is called as the first harmonic. Now see here, first is we consider as the n is equal to 1 upon lambda into under root of e upon m. We are using the one trick formula for it, that is the length of the one loop is equal to half of the wavelength, and therefore L is equal to lambda by 2. Then lambda is equal to cross multiplication, we get here the 2L, and then subtract the directly value of the lambda, that is N is equal to 1 upon 2L into under root of E upon M, and this we call as the fundamental frequency, or it is the first harmonics. Okay, now next we will learn that the second diagram for it. In second diagram, the again loop is formed, and in that case, in second diagram, node is formed at the center of it. At the rigid support, again there is a two nodes are there, but at the center, if you plug the center of this wire, then the two loop is formed. That's why we write how many nodes are formed, 3 nodes, and how many antinodes, 2 antinodes is formed. Okay, just simply we write here, this is the point is there where the antinode is formed, and then we complete the diagram of it. This is the wave which is the form. Okay, here it is reflected, incident ray is reflected back, and then it will be formed the two loops. Okay. How many loops are there? Two loops are there. Total length of the wire is N. Therefore, the length of this loop is, it is divided into L by 2, L by 2. Okay? Consider this is the length of the loop. If we take it as the total length is 10 cm is there. Therefore, the length of this wire will be the 5 cm. Like that, it is a two loops are there, and each one is having the equal length, and equally it is divided, that's why it is L by 2, L by 2. Got it? Then after that, use the formula for it. Again, it is the remaining part of it. Here, similar to it, frequency. Frequency we have to mention here. This is a frequency N1, in this case lambda 2. V is a constant, velocity V is equal to under root of E upon M, and here it will be changed as a N1 and lambda 1, N1, lambda 1, this will lambda 1, this is lambda, N1, lambda 1. This, all these things are similar to it, only the frequency and the wavelength is mentioned here, it is lambda 1, N1 and lambda 1. Again, we mentioned here N1 and lambda 1, here N and lambda. Okay? And then we got here the V is equal to N1 lambda 1, N1 is equal to V upon lambda 1, which is equal to 1 upon lambda 1 under root of T upon M. N1 is equal to 1 upon lambda 1 under root of T upon M. So, for this case, we erase all this part of it, and we are using the same formula for it. Now, what is that formula is there? Consider this point. From here, length of the one loop is equal to, or for length of the one loop is equal to half of the wavelength, and the length in that case for one loop, this is a one loop is there. In that case, length is lambda by 2. Simply write here lambda by 2, which is equal to, L by 2, which is equal to lambda by 2. Length of one loop is L by 2. Second loop is L by 2. For one loop, we can say the L by 2, and which is equal to lambda by 2. Then lambda is equal to, what is the wavelength of it? 2L by 2. Okay, I am not cancelling this 2 for it. Numerator and denominator, it simply shows that it is a 2 to get cancelled, but
For the mathematical next steps of it, we require the two parameters. N1 is equal to 1 upon lambda 1 under root of E upon N. So, fit this value. Here we consider the lambda 1, lambda 1, lambda 1. Because wavelength is change, we consider the lambda 1. Next is that N1 is equal to 1 upon lambda 1, substitute here the 2L by 2 into under root of E upon N. This is N1 is equal to 2 into 1 upon 2L. Directly I adjusted the term of it, and here it shows that 2 into previously equation number 1 we considered, from the equation 1 we got the fundamental frequency N1. Therefore N1 is equal to 2N. This is the important steps we got here. N1 is equal to 2N, and this N1 is equal to 2N in the equation number 2. This is called as the this N1 is equal to 2N. This is called as a second harmonic. Two number is that second harmonics, or it is a first overpole. Got it? Name here is given as the N1 is equal to 2N. Two number represented the second harmonics. And the after that fundamental frequency, next frequency we called as the overtone. Next one is the first value is there, that's why first overtone mentioned here. Now we come to the next diagram, that is the figure C. In that case, again we erase all this remaining part of it, otherwise you will be confused. In third diagram, that is a figure C, it represents the here the two nodes is formed along the string. At the end of it, node is formed, but at the along the string there is a two node is formed. Means 1, 2, 3, 4. How many nodes are there? 4 nodes. And the 1, 2, 3, 3 anti nodes are formed. Okay, then we will complete the diagram of it. Then it will be from the antinode point. These are the points. Like that, draw the diagram of it, because the length of the each loops are equal. That's why draw the diagram neatly. It should be the equal in length. 1, 2, 3 equal in length is there. Then complete the wave of it. Actually, diagram is very simple, but then you have to draw it correctly for the specific distance of it. Three loop is formed, each one is having the distances same. Three loops, total distance or total length of this wire is L. Already we mentioned here. And for the length of one loop is, it is three loops are there, length is divided into three. That is L by 3, L by 3. This will be becomes as a L by 3. From up to this, again up to this, up to this. Okay? Then we write here the which frequency is considered. Here frequency is the N2 and the wavelength is lambda 2. Like that we can say the length N2 and lambda 2. N2 and lambda 2 be the frequency and the wavelength of this wave in a third mode of vibration. Next is that basic formula, V is equal to under root of E upon N. V is equal to, what is the changes here? Here the frequency and wavelengths are changed. And we mentioned here N2 and lambda 2. Therefore, it will become as N2 and lambda 2. N2 is equal to V upon lambda 2. And then substitute the velocity value of it under root of E upon N. Then N2 is equal to 1 upon lambda 2 under root of E upon N. Again, I wrote the formula for it. Now, again, we are using the basic formula for it. What is that basic formula? Length of one loop is equal to half of the wavelength. But which wavelength is there? Lambda by 2. Therefore, it is written as lambda by 2 divided by 2. Length of one loop. How much it is there? Length of one loop? L by 3. Therefore, L by 3 is equal to lambda 2 by 2. Then lambda 2 is equal to 2L by 3. Got it? This value we are substituting in a previous equation. That previous equation becomes as N2 is equal to
3 upon 2L under root of E upon M, and which is M2 is equal to 3 into, separating the terms of it, we can take the simply, we can see the formula for the fundamental frequency. Okay, and this is becomes as a 3L. N2 is equal to 3L. Got it? N2 is equal to 3L means we can say that it is a, how much is the number is there? 3. 3 multiplied by fundamental frequency. Therefore, it is a, which harmonics is there? This is a third harmonics. And previously, overtone is a first. Now, this overtone will be the second overtone. This is a second overtone and third harmonics. Like that, we can get here the first equation. So, means we can get it is called as a third equation. From 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, 3, we can say that the we got the fundamental frequency. Next is the second harmonics. Next is the third harmonics. Means all the harmonics are present in the vibration of the wire along it, N2 and 3L. Fundamental frequency, first overtone and third, second overtones are present. In this way, we draw the diagram of it, 1 marks for the diagram, and the next is that the marks is divided for it, for the formula, and next for the N formula, 2N formula, 3N formula, that is half of marks is divided. And at the end, when we are writing the N, 2N, 3N, all the harmonics are present in this case, and then we get the half marks for that steps. Like that, for the description, half marks is there. Total is a 3 or 4 marks questions will be asked in a board exam. Thank you.